So many vital operations are served by spreadsheets in our day. Whether it's for planning, tracking, calculating, data mining, or sharing. It's also natural for them to grow quickly within our teams. Welcome to the Sheets to App Show, where we talk about how to tame these tabular beasts into productive applications. So my question to you, G Suiteers, is have you heard of AppMaker? Because it's a tool that empowers a wide range of individuals in an organization to turn important processes that live in spreadsheets, for example, into a full-blown database application using a drag-and-drop interface. If you haven't, I will walk you through some of the problems you can solve with it. For starters, AppMaker is currently part of Google's Office Productivity Bundle called G Suite, within the business, enterprise, and education SKUs at this time. It was originally created internally at Google to accommodate for the overwhelming demand for custom applications, and it is currently paired with a Google Cloud SQL database. This streamlines the creation of database web apps and offers automatic backups of the data, greater processing speed than a spreadsheet, and automatically scales user traffic. It also allows users to create, read, update, and delete data. There are two common users that gravitate to AppMaker. The first group are folks that have a background in spreadsheet functions and formulas, and are typically but not limited to people in roles in program management, asset tracking, finance, human resources, or support. A second group are developers or technical teams that have familiarity with web app languages such as HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Apps that are a good fit for AppMaker are spreadsheets that are frequently used. And the schema of those spreadsheets can be imported with a few clicks, creating what is known as a data model. A user interface can then be created by dragging and dropping a form widget, for example, into this gray canvas called the Data Model Editor. And to display the data entered, you can then create another page within the app and drag a table widget that is automatically bound to the data entered into that form. And based on the comfort levels of the application author, they can add further custom automation, such as displaying results based on the user's role, emailing those who were assigned a task or completed one, or auto-generating reports with fresh charts every week. One can also leverage advanced features, such as building relationships between tables, using custom CSS for UI modification, creating calculated fields via SQL queries, and constructing event-driven workflows via client and server-side scripts written in AppScript, which is similar to JavaScript. Also note, apps best suited for AppMaker fall within the categories of being relatively small and simple, like apps that have less than 15 to 30 pages or do not require a lot of custom backend integrations. If you do wish to build a larger or more complex app, we recommend using products from Google's cloud platform. You can, however, still use AppMaker to prototype smaller, feature-specific apps while they're built into a larger GCP app. A key differentiator for AppMaker is that it's designed with administrative security controls at the G Suite domain level, such as granting access to AppMaker authors based on what organizational unit an author is assigned within the G Suite admin panel. It also allows for an AppMaker author to collaborate during its creation or when support is needed after it goes live, since it has the same sharing permissions as a Google Doc. And authors can also implement page-level permissions. And from a reporting standpoint, we recommend using one of these four tools to measure impact. First, G Suite admins have the ability to see what apps have been built within the domain and by whom in their G Suite admin panel. Second, authors can measure their app's usage by pasting a Google Analytics ID into the app. Third, authors can create charts within the app using a chart widget to display summaries of data entered by users, such as these. And finally, AppMaker authors can consolidate both app usage and data summaries into a dynamic dashboard that's free to use called Data Studio, since it has built-in connectors. If someone else in your domain would like to use your app but make modifications based on their use case, you can share a template of it by clicking the Export button and then choosing to select the entire app or only specific features. For example, if I created a custom widget in my app that collects signatures electronically, and I would like to only share that particular piece of functionality, I can do so by checking the box of that specific feature, which is called a module. What's nice too is you can optionally choose to include the app's data or just its interface without any data. These exports are saved as zip files and can be saved in Google Drive to manage access or be embedded as links on a Google site, which is a website that also uses the same sharing controls as a Google Doc. The experience for a user on the receiving side is to download the zip file and simply click import from within AppMaker and choose that file. Even though these tools are most friendly when used in combination with Google Spreadsheets and Cloud SQL, folks with a developer background can choose to integrate their external databases or with other Google APIs, as well as any REST-based services such as Salesforce or ServiceNow. Hopefully, this summary gave you a better idea of what you can use AppMaker for. If you found this episode helpful, please like and subscribe. Cheers.